Do you know what I mean? Like, what is this? He's supposedly one of the pound for pound guys right now. I mean, you need to start making these fights and putting yourself out there, not tweeting something when you know you're never going to be brought in here at 120 pounds as on a southpaw when I'm facing an orthodox.
Connor, you did the Ali shuffle a lot today.
So I'll give this lady go.
Connor, you've come really far in life. Does it ever trip you out to kind of think of how life was to how life is now?
Of course. I mean, every day I wake up and I pinch myself. Like I said, I come from shows where I'm fighting in front of 100 people, and 70 of those people are family and friends of the people that are fighting on the card. That's where I come from, and that was 4 years ago, 4.5 years ago. So I've come a long way, and it's been one hell of a journey, and I always take a step out of it for just half a second, look around, be grateful for it, get back in and carry moving on forward.
Was this fight part of the plan?
People who are in the, maybe where you were at one point and have a big dream but don't think that it's possible, what do you have to say to those people?
Keep believing in your ability. Keep showing up and working hard. Look around everyone that's with you right now and celebrate them. Don't look around everyone that's with you right now and be like, I've got to go somewhere else. Because that's the mindset with a lot of fighters, I feel. They're always like, I've got to go here to get this training, or where I'm at is not good enough. Where I currently reside is not good enough. I've got to move to America. I've got to move here. I've got to do this, do that. And what that is, it's just from me looking at that, it's just a sign of a weak-minded fighter. You've got to put your feet down and believe what you're training and grow as a team, as a unit. It's exactly what I have done with my team. I haven't brought nobody outside in. No, let's say I reach out to one of these boxing guys. It's like, they don't want me to win anyway. And it's like, it's just a different energy. The only thing I wanted to brought in was people ready to fight. People that come here, let's fight. And my team stays my team. It's been the same thing. Of course, it's a different discipline now. But fighting is fighting. And we are true masters at fighting. That's it. We are a different breed when it comes to fighting. We understand it clearer and more precise than anyone on planet Earth. And that's my belief, and that's the belief that young fighters should have in their hometown coaches and their hometown people and their roots. And that is the secret to success. You celebrate your surroundings and you will succeed. You don't, and you run away. You're not only are you running away from your team and your people, you're actually running away from yourself. And you'll never, you're just another guy in another guy's gym. Do you know what I'm saying? You're not the guy in that gym. You're just a tour. You know what I mean? You're just a tourist.
Connor, Pacquiao called you out. Canelo called you out. Mikey Garcia wants to fight you. Who would you want to fight in boxing? I mean, you're facing Floyd now, but if you could line up some fights.
None of them really. I mean, Pacquiao wouldn't be a bad one because he has a name. I don't. Look what happened to him.